Queensland has today announced it will ease requirements for interstate travellers, removing the need for PCR tests for those travelling to the Sunshine State. The CEO of Queensland Tourism Industry Council, Daniel Gschwind, joins me now. Good afternoon to you, Daniel.
Good afternoon, Julie.
Well, Daniel, as of January 1, a negative rapid antigen test is sufficed to cross the border, and the Queensland government has also scrapped that day 5 test. What are your thoughts on the changes?
Well, Happy New Year, Julie. That's what I think. You know, it's a good start to the new year and certainly makes travel much easier for visitors from interstate and also, for that matter, Queenslanders travelling interstate and returning after that. So it's great news, a great boost to confidence for the industry and for the travelling public.
As it stands, how much of an impact is Omicron having on holiday plans?
Well, it certainly had led to some cancellations. We had a strong influx of visitors from interstate over the last few weeks since our state borders opened. About 400,000 border passes have been issued, we're told. That's great news, but some, unfortunately, were disrupted. Some travel plans were disrupted because the tests either couldn't be obtained interstate or not, the result weren't arriving in time for the travel. So the removal of these requirements now and moving to a rapid antigen test that you self-administer before you travel, that's a great step in the right direction, and it rebuilds confidence for sure.
Not to make this political, but the state's new chief health officer seems to have quite a pragmatic approach to things now. Does that fill the industry with a little bit more confidence about moving forward and keeping everything going?
Look, absolutely. It fills us with confidence that we stuck to the roadmap. You know, we had the announcement from the Premier a few weeks ago that the borders would open. They opened a few days earlier than predicted, which was great news. And most importantly, we stuck to the open border policy despite the emergence of Omicron in such a wave in New South Wales and Victoria. And the Premier stuck to the plan. And that is something we really welcome. And it indicates that as we learn more about how to deal with this pandemic, the better we can manage it and the more confident we can be about how it's being managed. So, and in a nationally consistent way, can I also say. That's good news for us, good news for the travelling public.
In New South Wales, the current close contact rules are crippling hospitality and tourism. We're hearing similar stories in Queensland. What do you make of the current close contact rules? Obviously, that will all be up for discussion at tomorrow's National Cabinet.
Well, about 2 weeks ago, 10 days ago even, we had some great uncertainty. We had some real problems where venues or a couple of venues were closed because the entire staff complement was deemed a close contact. That has led to immediate discussions between the industry and the government in here in Queensland, and some clarity was established now, and a close contact is only someone who's been in contact with an infected person for 15 minutes or more over a close distance. So having that clarified has reduced the likelihood that somebody is a close contact. It's still a concern, obviously, for business operators in an industry that is already plagued by staff shortages. We can't afford to lose any more. So any loss of staff is a problem, but at least it's better managed, more practically managed and more commonsensically managed.
Hundreds of thousands of people have been wanting to get back into the beautiful Sunshine State. What is the feedback on the ground from those in the industry that are finally getting to welcome these interstate travellers?
Look, we can't wait to see more of you. There's no doubt about that. There's certainly more optimism in the industry than there has been for probably 2 years. There were many twists and turns to this story across Australia, certainly also in Queensland. But the pent-up demand from interstate is strong, we believe. We've got what people want and deserve after 2 years of trauma. So we're ready to offer everybody a great time. Queensland is a big state with many experiences from down near the Tweed and on the Gold Coast all the way to Cairns and to the Outback. So we're ready to welcome you. And I've got to tell you, the operators miss the visitors. And it's not just business. It's genuinely a passion that our industry has for what they do. And the interaction with visitors is something they care about, their staff, they care about their staff. So to get business going again is good for the industry, good for the visitors, and also, importantly, good for the communities where this activity takes place. Tourism is part of the community throughout Australia, and we need to get it going again.
And we're so good at it here as well. You must be keen to get international tourists back.
Oh, absolutely. Look, that's the next hurdle, and we want to see the visitors back. And also, dare I say, we want to see the international arrivals who bring staff, you know, the working holiday visa makers who fill some of our jobs, the international students who do part-time work, and the skilled migrants. This country needs that migration flow of people who are skilled and ready to work, and we hope that starts going again. And we can have travel in both directions. You know, we are a connected society. We have friends and relatives overseas. Australia has a very, very high number of people who have family ties to overseas. We need to reconnect with the world, and the sooner this takes place, the better.
Well, I can confirm that I have a trip to Queensland in the diary for the end of January, so fingers crossed that I get there, Daniel, because it's been a long time coming.
I certainly hope you do, and I hope you got your rapid antigen test ready like I do for the travel. So that's all it takes. It's like a passport now, and hopefully it'll get you here and get everybody else here as well.
Don't you worry. I've got everything. I've got the booster. I've got the test. So I'm ready to go. Daniel Gschwind, CEO of Tourism, Queensland Tourism Industry Council. Thank you so very much for joining us.
Thank you, Julie.